Hello YouTube, Empathy Relics here, and today I'm bringing you guys a commentary talking about how we as a Call of Duty community can improve the franchise by not buying Infinite Warfare. So, for those of you who haven't seen the Infinite Warfare trailer, which I'm sure like 99% of COD players have seen it, it's set in fucking space, and no one wanted it set in the future. No one wanted another futuristic COD. They didn't listen. They went through with it, and the backlash they got is well deserving, to be honest. I think it deserved the amount of dislikes it got, because it just shows that the COD community is angry at Infinity Ward, angry at Activision. They were sick and tired of being fucking not listened to. And the only way we can change it is if we don't purchase Infinite Warfare or any Call of Duty products in the future until they fucking listen. So, we all need to fucking boycott purchasing Infinite Warfare, because all they are interested in is making profits, right? Keeping people playing and making profits so people buy the DLC and all that. That's all they care about. And proof of this is the constant supply drops and the hefty price of season passes and DLC and etc. And they just turned into such big fucking money whores. It's not even funny. It's wrecked the fucking franchise. Franchise that was once great has now fucking is just a shadow of its former self. And the only way we can make it change is by not giving them the fucking profits. So, we don't want supply drops. We already know there's going to be supply drops in fucking Infinite Warfare, because they already confirmed it with, like, the pre-order package. We don't want supply drops in a game that you have to fucking purchase. Like, yeah, you can earn them in-game, so reward the people who play the fucking game. Not like Black Ops 3, where they reward the people who are fucking are sad enough to spend big money on fucking supply drops. And the community doesn't want supply drops. We don't want fucking expensive DLC where they only give you 4 multiplayer maps and one other side thing. Simply not fucking good enough. You know, for like $25 or whatever it is per DLC, it's there's no value for money there. Especially when the DLC maps aren't that great. And no one wanted a fucking futuristic shooter. Everyone wanted either the Modern Warfare trilogy remastered, or a new Modern Warfare game, or a historical shooter. Instead, they set a fucking game in space further into the future. And they realized that the backlash they'd get, and they realized that their game wouldn't sell. So they fucking hired another studio to make COD 4 remastered, just to try and sell Infinite Warfare. And it's wrong. We should be able, if they're remastering COD 4, first of all, they should have done the entire trilogy together. It's fucking bullshit that they're not doing that. Second of all, they're only including 10 fucking maps, and the DLC isn't included. Like, what the fuck? And then, the third reason is you can't fucking buy it. It's not standalone. No one wants to play Infinite Warfare. Everyone wants to play fucking COD 4. And they know this. The fucking developers know that Infinite Warfare isn't gonna do well. So they chucked in fucking COD 4 and make you have to pay, like, I don't know what it is in America, but here it's like $120 just to get COD 4. You know, you have to buy Infinite Warfare to get COD 4. And the only way we can change that is if we boycott purchasing Infinite Warfare. So I want to play COD 4 remastered. I really want to get that game. I never played COD 4 before. I'd love to purchase that game. I'm someone who wants to play Infinite Warfare, but I definitely don't want to pre-order it. Definitely don't want to purchase it as soon as it comes out. I'd rather hire it or borrow it off someone to see whether I like it or not. And even then, I probably still wouldn't buy the game unless I absolutely loved it. And the chances of that being the case are like 1 in 100, really. Because I'm someone who doesn't really go through the honeymoon phase. I can judge pretty early on whether or not I'll like a Call of Duty, whether I think it's good or not. And I don't think Infinite Warfare is going to be good. And I think it's absolute bullshit that they're making us pay for Infinite Warfare just to get COD 4. So the only way we can change this is if we all boycott purchasing Infinite Warfare, we don't buy it, we don't give in to the fucking developers' demands, and we force them to fucking make a decision. Do they make COD 4 available for everyone to stand alone for like $30 or $40 or whatever, so they can at least make some money, or do they not fucking include it, and then lose massive amounts of money for the people who aren't purchasing Infinite Warfare for COD 4, who are only interested in getting COD 4, and they might get, you know, they might get, say, I'll just make up numbers here, they might get 10,000 people who buy Infinite Warfare for COD 4, but meanwhile you've got 500,000 people who just want COD 4, and if it was standalone they would buy it. So that's the only way we're going to get COD 4 standalone, is if no one buys Infinite Warfare. And so far, the pre-order sales are absolutely atrocious, so it seems to be working, and hopefully, if everyone boycotts purchasing Infinite Warfare, we can get COD 4 standalone, hopefully before Christmas. That's the ideal situation. Getting it around Christmas time a bit before would be great for everyone, including the developers. They'd be mad if they didn't do it, but, you know, it'd be admitting defeat, and maybe the COD developers are a little bit too proud to do that. But anyway, so I urge you all not to purchase Infinite Warfare if you only want to get COD 4, or if you're not that interested in getting Infinite Warfare. If you're interested in getting Infinite Warfare, by all means get it, and get the COD 4 version as well. That costs extra, but I honestly don't think you should be wasting your money on that. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this commentary, and I'll see you guys in the next one.